First of all, it is my proud privilege to welcome once again to all of you members present here. Actually, it is a actual, I should thank, compliment Mr. Kalia, who has brought all the members, all the stakeholders of the oil spill, actually, all the related to oil spill activities in this one board. And with this effort, I think he could mobilize people from all across this country, like oil exploration companies like ONGC, Oil India, plus downstream company IOC, SPCL, BPCL, plus also this Coast Guard, which is the nodal agency for this oil spill association, and other port trust, Navy, then marine management, salvage departments, port trust, ship builders, ship inspection team, so many people. As a matter of fact, I think I'm proud to say that about today, we have got about 27 members on advisory board. First time in Oil Spill in, Association, Oil Spill India conference. Although we have started from 2011, I'll come back to this point how it have started. And we have done second one is in also 2012 at Goa. Third one is also Goa on 2014. Because initially when we started in 2011, it is the first kind of this type of conference happened in India, because before it was not there. So we got a lot of response from the people and industry. And we have thought that Goa is the right place. Then immediately next year also they will continue every year. Also, no doubt we got a lot of good response from the industries in 2012 as well. But it was too hectic to organize such type of conference every year. Then we realized that to do it a better way, we should give some gap, some time. So it has decided to go for biannually. So instead of 2013, we have gone to 2014 in Goa. But again, when we thought about having this conference again in 2016, after 2 years, we realized that whether it will be better to have it in Goa or have it in Bombay. Because Bombay oil spill, if you talk about the marine oil spill, was coming to mind, then mostly we have affected the Bombay coast is mostly affected badly because of oil spill. And at the same time, most of the agency involved in oil spill, associated with oil spill activities, is stationed in Mumbai. Probably we will get better response or better support from the industries. So we have decided to go ahead this time in Mumbai, and it was decided to have it in 2016 August. I think date is 11-12, almost finalized. Mr. Abhishek, 11-12 August 2016, we'll have the fourth edition of Oil Spill India Conference in India, and that is Mumbai. And I, by seeing all your support, I could believe that I think it will be a successful event, and it will be, I don't say successful, I say the meaningful event where every industry, every partners are held and ultimately benefited, the ultimate benefit come to the country. So that is purpose. And if I talk about the background of this oil spill, how it has come out. You see, first of all, I just have to tell about mine, that I joined ONGC in 1976 as a gazetteer like Mr. Sudhubedi. We've gone together and working in different places. Ultimately, I came to the board of ONGC in 2004, and after 2 years of my as a director, I have been given the responsibility of the director in charge of safe, healthy, and environment. That time, our 2001, our new chairman, that time Mr. Subira joined. He has a lot of concern about the safety and environment. And immediately after joining, he has given a lot of responsibility to me that he could see a lot of oil spill taking place in on land. That time, we were not concerned much about the offshore activities. But because offshore actually we did not have that much of our concern, not much having accident, because one accident we had in Sagar because in 1984 probably, and that accident ultimately was our rig was burned, so therefore oil spill was not a concern, but concern was that how to cap that well. Ultimately it was could be capped with the invitation of the international expert. Ultimately it was closed. So that was the incident happened in offshore, but in onshore regularly we are having a huge amount of oil spill. That time there is no concern for us that for environmental damage because of crude oil spillage in the land areas. But it was a common practice to test the well in the land itself, and ultimately big pit was dug and oil was flown to this pit and ultimately left after our operation, and that pit became oil contaminated, we remain like that forever. And being oil is such an item which cannot be disposed or cannot be disposed by any means, it remained like that for years together. Ultimately, it contaminated the whole soil. So Mr. Raha has insisted that it should clean up. That time, we have that some R&D work was done with the TERI, that is the Energy Research Institute, and our IRS, Institute of Reservoir Study. They have developed some bacteria. That bacteria technology is called oil zapper technology, and that that successfully we could see that bacteria, special bacteria created for bioremediation of oil spill contaminated soil. Those bacteria were spread in the land contaminated with oil. Those and those bacteria itself is eating out all the oil and leaving the non-contaminated soil left for the fertilizer, for the farming. So that technology ultimately we have created a company that is called OTBL, ONGC Terry Biotech Limited, and they are in their company also. I was the first chairman of the company, and we have done many of the oil spill damage control mitigation work in online, not only for ONGC, Oil India, refinery like IOC, SPCL, also Reliance, even abroad. Presently their technology is applied in Kuwait oil field also. So that is the beginning, but that time in 2011, because of some incident happened in offshore, it was a really concern for us. One concern is that this pipeline, offshore tank pipeline for carrying oil from offshore to onshore, Udan, huge pipeline, 36, Mr. Basu, 36.
Two line.
This oil is springing, and that pipeline sometime leaks because of some reason, erosion or something happened that time. It is, I think, 21st of January 2011, that pipeline leaked. Ultimately, huge concern happened that is oil is coming out, and ultimately, immediately, of course, the support of Coast Guard and Navy, it could be contained because leakage was not very fast. Small leakage, I think within 8 hours, this oil could be contained, but about 80 million gallon of oil was gone through, and ultimately, immediately, because of facility available to close down the pipeline, so continuous flow was stopped. So therefore, leakage was limited, but that was also a concern. Most important concern we could face in April 2011, because of the deepwater horizon accident in offshore in Gulf of Mexico, and you know already that this BP has been facing a real problem from the US government, and this, you know, about 280 billion gallons of oil was spilled, and so many marine environment damage. With the support of the US government mobilizing so many resources, even then that could not be stopped, spilled to the shore. Ultimately, this oil spill has come to the shore, and you know all those marine environment ecological disbalance, everything happened in that area. Ultimately, huge losses of environment, ecological damage, really problem for the country like US. Ultimately, we have seen that this BP has to face a huge penalty. I think 24 billion penalty alone, plus the other expenses they have to bear for mitigation actions and control. After 86 days, that was controlled. That time, ONGC also having the deep water exploration campaign going on by deployment of 4 rigs. And that time, it was so much concern that such thing can happen in Indian Ocean also. Anything can happen. But ultimately, when we came to the, when we analyzed the problem, why it has happened, that is the most important, why it has happened, that could find that that is deepwater horizon, basically compromising on the safety as a result of the cause of this incident, which resulted in oil spillage. And again, blowout and oil spill. So therefore, but because of that, cutting down cost was the cause. That to cut down the cost, they have compromised many safety. But in case of oil exploration, compromise of safety cannot be accepted at all. Especially in deepwater, it is a zero tolerance. So that is the first emphasis given by our chairman, that no compromise on safety in deepwater drilling, and double check so that this type of incident never happened. Because if it happened, it will be disastrous to Indian Ocean. And we will not be able to control, mitigate the way this has been done in US, mobilizing so many resources, which we do not have today. So anyway, that was a concern that, and some other incident also happened, some collision of the boats, that is MSC, MCS Sitra and Khaliza 3. That also happened near to the coast, Bombay coast, and ultimately that accident happened, and ultimately there was a heavy damage to the port and coast, and ultimately found nobody is responsible. So therefore, in that time when ITN Media along with the Coast Guard approached ONGC that we should have some type of conference, technical conference, international conference, whereby you can bring awareness among the industries how difficult, how serious about oil spill is, especially in onshore environment. So that was the beginning, and ultimately with the support of the Coast Guard, and I have been asked to lead this conference. So since 2011, we have thought of, yes, this should be a good beginning in this line. So that was the beginning of oil spill India conference 2011 in September. We did first, so getting the support from that we are continuing. And there were only thing that through this conference we want to bring the awareness also that first of all the how to prevent this type of happenings. The prevention is always better. If it happens, then how the industry can respond to mitigate those type of damage control measurements to be taken by everybody. Because though the Coast Guard has been made the nodal agency, that is CC, I think Chief Coordinator Agency of this National Oil Spill Disaster Contingent Plan has been approved by the government in 1993, and Coast Guard has been given this responsibility for acting as a nodal agency for doing this, implement this plan. But I believe Coast Guard alone cannot do all those things. And there are many things to be done. At the same time, presently, I also believe that we do not have any national policy in oil spill management. That is a concern. I think I understand Coast Guard may be able to, Mr. Donny Michael, able to tell us that they have done many things. They have prepared, I think, policy on place, but it is not yet approved or not yet policy has come in place. As a result of this Indian Ocean, anybody can come and do that damage at the ocean and leave. Nobody can be immediately penalized. That's secondly, nobody knows how to take this initiative. Who should take the initiative? Because I think I remember the last conference, the Pollution Control Board of Maharashtra. They also really faced the problem when these two ships collided, MCS Citra and Khalija 3. Ultimately, all the oil spill in the tankers ultimately came to the shore. Now, it is very difficult for who to take initiative for mitigating this. And huge expenditure also involved. They told that they could only get 1 crore rupees from the Khalija, who left this place after his incident, I believe. He could get a PTC, MCS, similar, Kisse Mila Parani, but they got only 1 crore, but whereas damage was controlled by the more than 10 crore. So this was a type of situation we do not have today, and policy is not there. So that's why we are thinking that by organizing this type of conference, we want to bring awareness to the all concerned, and also plus resource, pulling resources from the everybody, because as per the new policy, the North DCP, the every company, oil industry has to have minimum tier one facility. So ONGC has got tier one facility, or Reliance has got, I think now Port Trust also developing this tier one facility. Ultimately, Coast Guard has to take initiative to take the lead and give a training to the people on time to time, so that any time this type of situation happens, immediately this can be mobilized from all resources and ultimately contain the spillage to have the minimum damage to the environment. So that is the purpose, and with that purpose, I believe that Mr. Kalia has taken a lot of initiative to mobilize all the people here in one board. And as he said, that we have got today 27 board members. All concerns are available in the board, and they could not come and because of various reasons, but they will be part of the advisory board. It's a large advisory board. We believe with your advice and guidance, this oil spill conference 2016 is a very meaningful conference, beneficial to all stakeholders. That is my purpose. With these few words, I once again welcome you to this first advisory board meeting of Oil Spill India Conference 2016, and wish and expect all support and suggestion. Actually, there is in between in this agenda, there is a, I believe, there is no point of there asking suggestion from the members present today. So that also we will be seeking from all of you. Even if you cannot give your suggestion today, by going through this presentation, all those things after this chronological event, you may have some points of suggestion or whatever you would like to have, so that it will be ultimately Oil Spill Conference 2016 should be a meaningful conference. So you can suggest through mail to Mr. Kalia or to me, so that those will be given due consideration in our agenda preparation of conference. So with this, again, I welcome you all of you. Wish you all the best.